What is up, my Squirtleites? It is I, your king, welcoming you to a brand new Let's Play. A Let's Play of what I think is still, to this day, one of the best shooters ever made, and that is none other than Star Wars Battlefront. The original Star Wars Battlefront, the only Star Wars Battlefront that has any relevance, because, let's face it, the 2015 and 2017 products by EA can die in a fire. Star Wars Battlefront 1, originally released for the PlayStation 2, the Xbox, and I believe this one got a PC release. I know the second one did, but I'm not entirely sure about the first one. Regardless, Star Wars Battlefront 1, fan-frickin-tastic game, and we are going to be jumping on into the two campaigns that are spread across Star Wars Battlefront. Campaigns I've actually never played. I've spent a lot of time in the instant action modes of this game. Just playing on all the maps because, I mean, that's honestly the best way to play Battlefront, but never really touched the campaigns before, so this is going to be a first for me, honestly, just as much as it is for any of you who are watching who don't really know about these games, because they're honestly forgotten classics. They really are, and I'm going to be skipping this because I don't want to show actual movie cutscenes, because that would be bad, and I could easily get myself hurt by copyright and possibly get this video blocked, and I don't want to do that. So we're going to start with the Battle of Naboo. This is the beginning of the Clone Wars campaign, obviously. The Gungan Grand Army is trying to liberate Theed, destroy the mobile shield generators by eliminating all the Fabas. Yeah. Okay, so I believe we are going to be playing as the droids for this, and then jumping on into the Naboo map. It just uses the instant action maps and then kind of retools them for the campaigns, much like it did in Battlefront 2. Okay, so we are going to start. Let's start here. We'll be using battle droids for this. So controls are pretty darn simple. There is no sprinting, I believe, in this one, unlike Battlefront 2. So L2 is to throw grenades. That's also going to hurt one of my teammates because I'm a genius. R2 is to shoot. And then the bumpers are how you switch your weapons. And that's pretty much all there is to it. So I am playing this on the Xbox, Xbox One through... I think this is through Game Pass, if I'm not mistaken. I can't actually remember if I actually bought these or not, or if I just have it through Game Pass. But honestly, these are just such excellent ways of... These are just such excellent games, and I highly recommend giving them a shot. Freaking well done. Some of the best third-person shooters around. I'm going to try to capture this command post before anybody gets anything. I'm going to reload real quick. There we go. Okay, so this droid right here heals you. This droid right here gives you more ammo should you run out. You have two different kinds of grenades, thermal detonators and concussion grenades. Concussion grenades, ow. Concussion grenades are more for sticking to things, sticking to objects and doing damage that way. And thermal detonators are for splash damage and trying to get damage done that way. Can I actually get into this thing? Is it going to let me? Let's see. Okay, cool. So I can get in this thing. These AATs are actually pretty darn powerful. Unfortunately, I can't break through this. I don't think I can. I think I can go through the shield like this just fine, and I have to kill these things to actually be able to break through. So let's try to do this with taking as, you know, as little damage as possible, which is going to be kind of unavoidable. What is shooting at me? That's you. Okay, hold on. Let's get rid of this turret here. There we go. This thing absolutely just tears through every single enemy that I shoot. So let's see. Get rid of you. Spawn kill! Jeez, that was just brutal. Okay, let's see if we can get rid of this thing. Okay, ow! Frickin' rude, first of all. This thing has a lot of splash damage, too. I'm gonna need to bail out of this thing, actually, really quickly here. So, I don't think I can do a whole lot of damage. Oh, no, there we go. So, we took down one of them. That gets rid of the shield, which is exactly what I need to do here. Alright, so. Working our way through. I probably should heal. Actually, I did not mean to shoot you. Alright, does it have an objective for me yet, or do I just need to capture each one of the bases? I think I just need to capture each one of the bases. So let's get over here, and I'm going to actually try to take care of this one, because this is kind of giving the Gungans a bit of a flanking point. Oh, this thing is weak. Never mind. Screw that. So we're going to start by trying to pop each one of these guys out of their little turrets, just like that. There we go. Get out of there. Thank you. They're not very strong. I think Gungans only, like, their only method of attacking is throwing grenades. I don't think they actually have any guns whatsoever, if I'm not mistaken. So, pretty weak, though. So, if they start shooting at me, that would be bad. There we go. There we go. We're doing good. Okay. Yeah, I think that's why this is the first level, honestly, is because these guys don't even have guns. Okay. Ironic for being called Gungans, but they don't have guns. Okay. Let's move on up to the last command post and start taking them out. I'm probably going to die. I didn't see a health droid over there, though, which was my problem. So, keep moving. You can always issue commands with teammates using the D-pad. Follow me, at ease, move out, hold position, all that stuff. And then, obviously, to kind of zoom in, you click in on the right stick. Although, this is actually pretty darn useful, if I'm being honest. It allows you, it makes it much easier to aim if you do that. So, would highly recommend using that to the best of your ability, especially since this game kind of is pretty dependent on lock-on and auto-aim, if I'm being honest. Just because, well, it's an early third-person shooter. It's not, like, this was, like, Battlefront 1, if I'm not mistaken, was only, like, a year or two into the PS1 and Xbox's life cycle. So, it's really not that, modern of a game. My goodness. Okay, so I need to stay by this thing if I can. This one's going to be a very slow capture because it's a much bigger base. So, I need to be very careful about this. Oh, they've already taken down the health droid. I really need that. Sometimes the enemies will drop health, but I'm not really seeing it. And I can't camp inside the turret and kill them that way, otherwise it won't capture the point. So I think if we just get all the kills, we might actually just be done, if I'm not mistaken. But I'm going to capture this base just to be safe, because once you have control of every single base, it just starts to wind down their numbers until they die. And that's it. You got them? There's one left. Let's see. Yeah, there you go. Victory in 20. Okay, so let's just kill this last one wherever he is. There you are. Get out of here. And we're done. And that is the first mission in Star Wars Battlefront 1. Pretty darn simple. It's going to get a little more complicated as we go, obviously. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be it for this episode of Let's Play Star Wars Battlefront 1. I hope you all enjoyed it very much. I know it was a short episode, but still trying to figure out the cadence of these episodes and whatnot. But obviously, these are going to be going up twice a week, and this game is not really that meaty to begin with when it comes to the campaign lengths. Like I said, I've never played through the campaigns, but if they're anything like Battlefront 2's campaigns, it's going to be pretty short. So we're going to try to make this Let's Play last a little bit longer. So with that said, thank you all so very much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one.